So today we are here to tell you that the foods that claim that they are healthy are not that much healthy. Also, if they are healthy, they are not good for your pocket at all. So yeah, I'll just try to explain this thing to you, and we'll start it by just saying this word that home food is really healthy. And if you want healthy food, then prefer home food. Nothing else. Like seriously. Okay, so do you remember when you were young and when you were a small child, the first bite that was given to you was the home food. It wasn't any packed item from the market that used to, claim that we are really healthy. It was not that, right? When we give something to a child first time, we give home food. We don't give some supplement or something, some healthy, something nutrition food that we'll buy from the market and we'll give. We never do like that, right? So that is my point, that in childhood and in the young ages, we heard that the healthy food is the home food. So these were the synonyms. So why is it changing now? Literally, why? I would just like to tell you a little bit history about it. Earlier we were having home food itself, but in 1990s this breakfast concept came into the picture. It was like that you have to eat cornflakes and the juice on the, you have to sit on dining table and you have to eat and drink all those things that used to happen. So everybody was like, okay, this is healthy now. What we were doing till now was not at all healthy. I don't understand. If it was not healthy, then how people were living? So actually, it is something that we all should think upon. So now, this is the thing. Then green tea came, smoothie came, many seeds came, like chia seeds, mustard seed, all these things came. And then it's 2020. Anybody can say, literally anyone and everyone can say a lot many things about 2020. I'm damn sure about it. Be it employee or a student or an intern or anybody, they can say a lot about it. 2020 has not been that great for us humans, but yeah, I would like to say, add one more thing to the list is this, this faith, this blind faith in the healthy items that we have is also one, bad thing that 2020 has done to us. You might have heard that all the things like your favorite things are the ice cream, milk, and your chocolate bars, everything is healthy. That's healthy and it increases your immunity. This is like a marketing strategy that each and every company has adopted. They have adopted this work that, okay, immunity. Everybody needs immunity. Everybody needs healthy life. Okay, we'll launch our products and we'll write at the below, on the carton that it's healthy, it's organic, it's nice, and it will increase your immunity and the person will buy. Seriously, it's their marketing strategy, that's it. And okay, coming to it, okay, if I'll say our favorite things like these, I said the chocolate bars, ice creams, it is still fine. I'll say that, okay, I spent a lot of money, but still, because it's my favorite, I ate it. So what? It's okay. Theek hai. Money was spent a lot, but okay, I ate it, right? Then, but the issue is here is the people will come and will send you such items that you don't even eat, and they will make you feel that you want it, you really want it. That is, like they market it in a such way that it is, it's known as urgency marketing. They market it in a such way that you feel, oh, I really need it, I really needed it, and I didn't even realize. So that is the thing over there. For example, I'll just take my example itself, that I had this protein powder, not protein powder exactly what I'll say. Yeah, but you can say that immunity increase, well, it's an immunity powder or something, and it was of 3,000 or 4,000, I guess. And I hate it. I hate the smell, I hate the taste, I hate it. I didn't even, eat the powder. I don't even taste it. But just because at that time I felt, okay, it's so much necessary for my health, it's so much necessary for my life, it's so much necessary for my immunity. I bought it. But what now? It's there lying in my cupboard. Seriously, it's doing nothing. Walls of my cupboard are seeing it. Nobody else. Also, I will just, quote an example of green tea here, so that you can understand the point even in a better sense. You all might have drunk green tea once in your lifetime. If not on the daily basis, I know many people drink it on daily basis. If not on daily basis, you might have drank it once in your lifetime. It's nice, right? The taste is awesome. Actually, I know the answer is no. The taste is not awesome. The taste is pathetic. That taste is actually pathetic. A person, if you will give green tea to a person, to a random person, that person will be like, why do you hate me so much? Why you give this thing to me? But after we came to know its benefits, we were like, okay, green tea is very nice. We should drink it. But you know what? Sorry to burst the bubble, but green tea only and only improves metabolism. Nothing else. Seriously, nothing else. There are some girls, I'll say most of us, we drink green tea thinking that it will help us in losing weight. I would say that yeah, it helps us in losing weight by what? By improving metabolism. If you will do workout, if you will do exercise with the green tea, obviously you will, you know, lose weight. But if you will only count on the green tea, I don't think it will help you. Similarly with the protein powder. All the gym freaks and all the YouTubers, you know, YouTubers, big YouTubers, even not even the small, but big YouTubers, they are like, you know, you should have a protein powder. It's really nice. It's awesome. It's good for your body. It's good for your health. You will not feel tired. These 3 spoons, 4 spoons. Okay, now do it with water and all those things. And when we come to the price, yeah, price is a lot. But what they say, it's okay. It's healthy for us. But do we really think that it's healthy for us? What is protein powder actually doing? Literally, what is protein powder doing? It's just a supplement, nothing else. If your body hasn't, you know, reached or attained that vitamin and protein, then protein powder, you know, then protein powder is being taken. And literally, you know, that supplement is like 47 grams for women and about 50 for men. You can also complete that supplement thing by having eggs, meat, or by even by green vegetables. You don't have to buy 4,000 or 5,000, 6,000 protein powder and then to drink it. It's nothing, it's just a supplement. That is it. Also, next I would like to talk about cow milk. You know, in childhood we were taught that cow milk is the best. It's very nice for us. And we all used to have this. I still remember that in my home it used to come buffalo milk, and in my aunt's home it used to come cow milk. So when I used to drink that cow milk, my mother used to tell me that yeah, it's healthy, it's very nice. So I asked like, why we are not having it? So she said that okay, it doesn't taste so nice. But after that we also started having it. So we both were like having cow milk. And I'm sure that many of you, if not now, earlier, you'll be having cow milk. But what happened now? Soy milk, almond milk, all these things have come in the market. And we have replaced soy milk, almond milk with the cow milk. And what these companies claim, that cow milk is very bad. You should not drink cow milk. Cow milk increases the fat. I'm like, how? Do you have any proof? And if this is the case, then the people that earlier lived, they all should be fat, right? Why the laborers were slim? Didn't they get it? Why the people were slim? Why the models were slim? Why the actors were not that healthy? Why? I mean, seriously, why? It's a thing to actually think ki why this is happening. And seriously, I don't think that nutrition that cow milk gives us, soy milk or almond milks can give us. Obviously, it's very good that you have almonds, but replacing it, it's a substitution, just, you know, avoiding it, that thing, cow milk from your life, I don't think it's cool. The next example can be gluten free. I mean, okay, it's only necessary for someone to go gluten free if they have allergy with gluten. You know what gluten is? It's just an amalgamation of various proteins that is actually necessary for our health. But just to follow the trend, and because of the convincing power of the companies, we all thought that we should go gluten free and that will actually increase our immunity. But actually it's not so. Also, coming to the brown alternatives, that is brown rice, brown bread, brown sugar, we all tend to think that brown is better. You know, brown rice is better, brown sugar is better, brown bread is better. But I say that how? Seriously, how? I mean, like, it's just our perception that companies have said. If you actually go and if you see the ingredients of them, they are more or less the same. It's nothing else. Also, the only one thing is that they are really expensive than the white things. Yeah, I myself have these things, so I know that these are really, really expensive. I had once, so I know. I can say also what these companies are doing. They're actually, you know, hiding the harmful ingredients, you know, with their chemical name. For example, MSG. It's usually written as E621. Now people know what is MSG, but they don't know what is E621. So they're like, okay, it's fine. So that is what these companies are doing. Ingredients will be the same, but they just changed the name from the common name to the chemical name, to the technical name, so that people think that okay, this thing doesn't contain that. I just want to say at the end that please don't get fooled by these companies, by the advertisements. They are just doing it. The YouTubers and Instagrammers, they all are doing it because they are getting money for it. You are not getting money for it. You are actually paying money for all these things. So please take care of the money that you or your parents have earned. Don't spend it like that. So yeah, at the end, I just want to say, just take good care of yourself, and I still feel that home food is the best. So yeah, and also the stats show this thing. So yeah, take good care of yourself, especially in this pandemic, and as much as possible, be in your home and have home food. Bye bye.